F of 0 is 0 and F double dash exists on 0 to infinity, open semi open intervals, show that fx f dash x minus fx by x is equal to half x f double dash j, such that this j is in between 0 to x. Now, and deduce, and hence if f double dash x is greater than 0, positive, for all x greater than 0, then fx upon x is strictly increasing in open interval 0 to infinity, because 0 cannot be taken because there is an x at the denominator. That's why 0 is in the open interval. Now let us define this function. First, let us write it down. X f dash x minus fx is equal to half x square f double dash j is equal to 0. So let us rearrange it properly. Fx minus x f dash x plus half x square f double dash j is equal to 0. Now let us define a function phi x as fx minus x f dash x plus a x square. Now phi x is continuous on, say, 0 to some point x. You know this some point x. Now this phi x is derivable on 0 to x. This type of problem we have already done earlier, this concept. Now select a such that phi of 0 is equal to phi of x. So this is the third condition. So let us first select. Now phi of 0, let us see what is phi of 0, because f of 0 is 0. So phi of 0 is f of 0 minus 0 into f dash 0 plus a 0 square. So this comes out to be phi of 0 is 0. So phi of x also has to be 0 because of this condition. All the conditions of Rolle's theorem are satisfied. Since all the conditions of Rolle's theorem are satisfied, there exists, let me write down, as all condition of Rolle's is satisfied. So there exists a C belonging to, there exists a J belonging to 0 to X, such that phi dash J is equal to 0. Now let us find phi, what is phi x, let us see. Phi x is fx minus x f dash x plus a x square. So phi dash x is f dash x minus f dash x, product rule, minus x double dash x plus 2ax. Now phi dash j is equal to 0. That means f dash, this cancels out, by the way, they cancelled out. So what you are left with, let me rewrite this. What you are left with phi dash x is equal to minus x f double dash x plus 2ax. Now, as per this condition, phi dash xi is 0. Therefore, phi dash xi is equal to 0 implies minus xi. This gives minus xi f double dash, wait a minute, f double dash xi plus 2a xi is equal to 0. This xi goes off. A comes out to be half f double dash xi. This comes out to be, so let's put it back. Let's put it back in this equation, in this phi x equation. Where is this phi x equation? Here. Let us put it here in this phi x equation. Phi x equation, let us put it here. Let us put it here in the phi x equation. So phi of x is equal to f of x minus x f dash x plus half x square f double dash j. Now phi of 0 was equal to 0 is was equal to phi of x. So f of x minus x f dash x plus half x square f double dash j is equal to 0. Now this condition fx minus x f dash x plus half x square f double dash x f double dash xi is equal to 0 for all for xi between 0 to x some x. Now you see one thing, and from here we can do one thing. Let us rewrite the whole thing that way. Let us shift this on the other side. So this becomes f dash x minus f dash x, x f dash x minus fx is equal to half x square f double dash xi. It is ko udhar shift kar diya, right side way. Now divide by x, f dash x minus f of x upon x is equal to half x f double dash xi. And this condition also is holds xi in between 0 to x. So this part has been proved. Now we will see the next part, that is this part. I'm talking about this still increasing. Hence, if f dash is greater than 0, then fx upon x, this part, you have to show this part now, is strictly increasing. You have to show this. So now take gx, some small gx. Gx equal to fx upon x. That's right. Now we need to find what is g dash x. Now g dash x increasing and decreasing, we need to show. If g dash x is greater than 0, it is increasing. If g dash x is less than 0, then gx is increasing and gx is decreasing. This is the concept we now need. So g dash x is f dash x minus fx using numerator denominator rule upon x square. Now you see, this can be written as this whole thing I'm writing in this form. This form is to be written in this form. See what happens. What happens, you see. Now see what happens. Here you see, we know f dash x minus fx upon x is equal to half x f double dash z. This we know. Now if you do this x f dash x minus fx upon x is equal to half x f double dash j. Now cross multiply, bring it here. X f dash x minus fx upon x square is equal to half, wait a minute, half f double dash j. Now this f double dash j, now this is f double dash j. So from this concept, this will become this g dash x. Let us see what happens with g dash x. G dash x is equal to x f dash x minus f x is x square. This is nothing but half f double dash j. F double dash j. And this quantity is greater than 0 because they have said, if f dash x, this in the question they have said you. See, in the question only they have said you. There, this is the question. This is the if f double dash is greater than 0, this f double dash is greater than 0, in the question they have told you. So this quantity g dash x is greater than 0 implies gx is a g dash x is greater than 0, that means g dash x is greater than 0 for all x greater than 0. So this is an increasing function. So this is gx is increasing. Gx is increasing. Increasing. Now what I do is that, I use Lagrange mean value theorem for two points, x1 less than x2. I am using Lagrange mean value theorem for x1 less than x2 belonging to both x1 comma x2 belong to 0 to infinity. This open interval 0 to infinity. Open interval. Now what happens is that, see this. See this now. G of x1, g of x2 minus g of x1, x1 upon x2 minus x1 is equal to g dash, some point say g dash theta, where theta, this theta is not an angle, this is some number between x1 and x2, where x1 is less than x2. That means, now see one thing, now since this g dash is greater than 0 for all x, so this is greater than 0, this quantity is greater than 0, g of x1, x2, x2 minus x1, g of x1 upon x2 minus x1 is equal to g dash theta, which is greater than 0, that implies gx2 is greater than gx1. So for x1, x2, gx2 is greater than gx1, implies gx is strictly increasing function, implies, so gx is strictly increasing, strictly increasing function, increasing function. Why? See, I'm repeating, x1 less than x2, we got gx1 less than gx2, that's why.